Hello everyone, how are we? Hope you're well. Welcome, welcome, welcome. It's Tuesday, isn't it? Another start of another week, a start of another fun week ahead. Obviously this week we've got not just streaming here, we've got the Football Manager show comes out tomorrow. So very, very excited about that. That's episode one. Plus, it's the FM playoffs this week as well. And I've had a quick little look at the game tonight, and it looks like we've got 16 games to go in the season. Norwich just might end up being a Premier League side. So here we have it. This is where we are. We're currently second in the championship. If you remember back from Saturday night when we did the charity stream for the Samaritans, and thank you, by the way, for everyone who jumped into that and donated money. They raised a lovely amount of cash. Dan there, Dan FM, in with the 16 months on Prime. Dan, appreciate that. That's very, very kind of you indeed. You're a wonderful human being. Thank you very, very much for that evening indeed. Let me just very quickly, I need to potentially try and do that screen again because it's not pinging in my ears. That, I don't know if you got an alert when that happened, but it didn't ping in my ears. So I need to maybe try and have another look at that one. So we'll get that one fixed. But hey, we had some tech issues the other night. They're fixed now, we think. So as I say, believe it or not, you got the alert. There you go. All right, it's just in my headphones. It's not working. So this is where we are. We're currently second in the championship. Look at this. Incredible. Sunderland top, obviously. We're 2 points behind. We're currently like 14 points clear of Hull. Look at this though. I mean, this is proper Jameson territory, right? Apart from this top, obviously. Evening, I'm at it, striker. How are you, buddy? We dropped, we're back up, and we're there again. So we're here or hereabouts, right? Look at this. Look at all this green. This, however, was the issue. Two defeats back-to-back. Sunderland and Middlesbrough, 1-0 defeats, and then a 1-0 defeat against Hull. So we've not conceded more than two goals when we lost. In fact, we've only conceded two goals a couple of times this season. So we yet to concede three. Don't say that too loudly, Tony. We're about to play Middlesbrough now in the FA Cup. But that's where we are. We're heading towards the promised land of the Premier League. We've got nine seasons into this save. I think, given how the game cycle currently is, I think we've maybe only got one season left in this save, and we're going to take it to 10 seasons. That'll be it. This guy, by the way, if you didn't see him the other day, Jackie Girardet is the next Michel Platini, apparently. So he's quite a talent. We won't be getting him. The transfer window is open, so we'll hopefully try and sign a couple of players as well. So we might not finish the season tonight, to be honest, but we'll definitely finish it tomorrow. And that's sort of where we're going to be looking at. Evening, Richard Wright. How are you, my man? Welcome in. Pleasure to see you. We, of course, do need another striker. We need to take a little bit of pressure off Adam Ida, I think. The horse, Chevalier, he's still there. He's only got us one goal, but he's played seven games well, so we're not really relying on him too much. Ryan Ewins, I think Liverpool are going to cut him loose and try and take him back, which is fine. He's only scored one goal for us in 11 games, so if he goes back, he goes back. So I think we need a goal scorer. I think we need somebody else up front to put the ball in the net. Now, who that's going to be, I've got no idea, really. We have got a couple of bids in for players at this moment in time. So we have bid for this guy. We've bid for George Hargreaves, £8 million worth of West Ham defender. So Dave Goodger, when he comes in the chat, he'll be really, really excited about that. £8 million worth of West Ham defender. Looks pretty tasty, to be honest, for a 23-year-old. He should sort of do us when we get into the Premier League as well. Decent jumping reach, decent heading, very brave, decent leadership. Positioning's pretty good, tackling's pretty good. So, and he can play in a number of positions as well. So, thinking he could be a decent shout. Gavin Bazunu we might be in the hunt for as well, at £2 million. He could be a tidy little backup goalkeeper as Victor Johansson is off to Lokomotiv Moscow. We're also going to try to sign Jan Kramer from Rangers. Now, the issue was we tried to sign him, but they're under a transfer embargo, so we're going to have to try and sign him for the end of the season on a free instead. So, shame. We could have done with him now. 17 for passing, 16 for vision. great jumping reach for a 6 foot one midfielder. Loads of ability for leadership as well there. Determination's pretty high. So thinking he could be quite a handy little player in that midfield. And then here we are up top. Jose Soto is the man we've looked at from Everton. 18 to 20 dribbling. Finishing of 12, but you know, he's got a good acceleration as well. Very well balanced. He plays out wide, but I reckon we can sort of move him in. He can play up front if needs be as well. So that's the striker we're going for. 8 caps for Mexico, 2 goals. He's the man we think is going to be the guy that's going to work alongside Adam Ida, potentially. And if that deal doesn't come through, then we'll go and we'll look for somebody else. And in fact, there you go. Jan Kramer has just agreed to go and join Nottingham Forest rather than us. So that's not how the stream's supposed to start, to be honest, losing players to Nottingham Forest. But there you go. Matty Adair, lad from Tottenham, not quite at the level we need right now. Obviously we are looking for players who are going to be Premiership ready, because that's realistically where we think we're going to be next season. And if we're not going to be Premiership ready with Norwich, we'll be Premiership ready with somebody else, because we will have to leave and go and find somewhere else to manage, because that's pretty much where we are with the save now. We need to get into the Premier League next season, and we're going to have to be a bit ruthless, really. We've not got much time left in this save until FM23 comes out. So here we go. £8 million worth of Jorge Hargreaves. And our £19 million budget has just taken a bit of a hit. We're after a striker. We've bought a centre-half. That seems about right, to be honest, for us. But, you know, they're happy with that. B+. Very happy to confirm the signing of a talented player. And I think, yeah, I think for 10 grand a week, we've got ourselves someone decent here, to be honest. His teamwork's maybe a little bit low, and maybe his work rate's a little bit low as well. But I think overall, I think he's going to add a bit of depth to us. Ian Sittle's playing well. Tipple's playing well. Kerr Smith wants to go out on loan. And Sean Jacobs isn't quite at the level yet, despite being 6'7", despite being 22 years old. He's not quite at the level. So if we have Hargreaves in here, then at least we've got someone who can jump in straight away and be a physical presence at centre half, rather than Sean Jacobs, who's potentially not quite the player that we hope he's going to be at this moment in time. So there's our first signing so far. We'll have a look and see what else we can get in over the line as we go. But hope everyone's well, by the way. Hope everyone's had a lovely weekend. And yeah, I hope you're excited for a good week. Hope you've got some stuff planned. Hope you're excited for the FM Football Manager show tomorrow. Very excited to get it recorded. Very, very excited. It still feels weird to say that it's going to happen, but it's absolutely going to happen. Gavin Bazunu is in. Look at that. There you go. £2 million. Gavin Bazunu. What a signing that's going to be. Backup goalkeeper. Yes, lads. Happy. Very, very happy. Richard Wright had a cold over the weekend. That was never fun. Ooh. Getting better, I hope, though, Richard. Getting better, I hope. I'm on the old Lemsips tonight. So just to make sure that we keep any colds at bay. Wasn't a great weekend. Stepped on a nail, stuck at home. Oh, Jesus, Raju. That's not pleasant. Not pleasant at all. Evening, Inky. How are you, buddy? Yeah, hope you're feeling well, though, Razio. Did you have to go to hospital for it, or did it pierce the skin? Inky's really well. Yes, mate. I'm very good. I'm very good. Thank you. Very good indeed. I'm in a pleasant mood today, so it's not very often I can say that, I don't think. But I will say it. I will say it today. So yeah, hopefully we can get some, as I say, we can get some fun results here tonight. Get as close to finishing the season as we can, and then all of a sudden, season 10, and then that's us for the story hunter for the year, I think. Not great. 4 hours in A&E, went through a toe. Poor Raggio. Raggio, that's, mate. I feel for you, man. I really feel for you. We had Littlest Jameson in A&E again the other day because he decided to run into a door. So I know I shouldn't laugh. Soto's gone to West Ham, and so's Hansen Arlen as well. So, right, we've lost out on a striker. We've also lost out on a very, very exciting midfielder who we couldn't really afford, if I'm honest. So I'm not massively concerned about that one. Win Idzi. Swansea not doing great, to be honest. Zimmy. I presume it's pronounced Zimmy. I'm guessing that's how it's going to be. Zimmy, first time in the chat. Can't wait for the beta. Join the club. We're all very, very excited for the beta. Should we try and sign a Rezo? Rezo's not been a bad person in real life. Has he? £18 million? We haven't got the money for a Rezo, but we'll keep it there for now. I think we're all very excited for the beta. Who are you going to manage in the beta, Zimmy? What's your team of choice? Have you already worked that out, or are you trying to sort of like play it a bit by ear and make a decision a bit closer to the time? Dean O'Connor, really, really fast. Reasonable finishing and free. Leuven, oh, excellent. Excellent. So that's over in Belgium, isn't it then? So that should work pretty handy. I'm excited for that. So where would he fit? Let's keep a little shortlist on you, Mr. O'Connor, because I think the fact you're fast and can score is quite handy. Ian Hogan's a midfielder. Kevin Reid. Beta won't be too long now. Not really, Inky. It should be on its way. What we got now? We've got just under a month for the full release. So, yeah, even if we take an educated guess, or should we say an educated guess? Or should we say, let's just take a conservative estimate that we're going to be talking maybe a couple of weeks between game launch and beta. So yeah, we should only be sat waiting for another couple of weeks, and then we'll be in. You know what, I've looked at Evan Ferguson a few times. I think he's the man to go for, possibly. Let's try and bring him in. November 8th is indeed the release. If you haven't pre-ordered Football Manager 23, by the way, do yourself a favor, get it ordered. Use my code, get you the game for £32.05, which is cheaper than Steam, and you do get guaranteed. Yes, Kegman, how are you, buddy? Welcome. Big shout for the Kegman. If you haven't followed Kegman, please, everyone, do us a favor and give the man a follow. He's a top dude, is Keg. We love him over here. I'm very good, thanks, Keg. I was just saying, I'm in a good mood tonight, so I'm very happy about that. We're just trying to wrap up this save before FM23 comes out, and we're just trying to plug a few bits of merch. We're trying to plug some sales here, to be honest. We're just popping out the old FM23 link. So can I still pre-order when the beta gets released? Yeah, so basically you can, Inky. So essentially what happens is you can use that code like forever. So even like when the game's properly released, you can use that code and it keeps working. The only reason I'm saying use it now to pre-order is that people obviously want to get the beta. So if you want to get the beta, you can pre-order it now and you'll get it in time for the beta. It will literally just drop straight into your Steam account. It is an official Sega licensed store as well, so there is all above board. But yeah, if you want to save a few pennies, mate, it's certainly no rush. There's going to be plenty of time for FM to still be sort of like kicking about, so you'll still get your money's worth regardless of when you buy it. But yeah, I know exactly what you mean, Keg, about having a night off. It's a rare occurrence. It's a rare occurrence, isn't it? When beta is released, if I pre-order it, then can I still play the beta? Yes. So if you, yeah, basically as long as you get it before the main release. So say for example the beta comes out tomorrow, but you buy the game on the 5th of November, you can still play the beta for 2 days, if that makes sense. I guess that's sort of what you're asking, really, isn't it? So yeah, you don't have to pre-order the game pre-beta. As long as you purchase the game before the 7th of November, you'll still be able to play the beta. And then when it rolls out on the 7th of November, the game just automatically becomes the full version. So that makes more sense. Disappointing to see that we've conceded a goal already against Middlesbrough here. We're just sort of like just chilling tonight, just chatting away. Not really focused just yet on the match. It's the FA Cup. We don't need the FA Cup, to be honest. We need league wins. That's what we need. Bozanek, look at the 6 minutes in and we're already 2-0 down. This is why I'd said, oh, we've never conceded more than 2 goals this season. Why did I say that before a football match? Stupid, absolutely stupid. Right, berate them. We've been playing FIFA to tide you over till FM comes out. Oh, okay. Apparently everyone says that FIFA's meant to be quite good this year. I've not tried it myself, so I can't say one way or another, but by all accounts it's meant to be a good FIFA. So if anybody can confirm or deny, that'll be interesting. I'm gonna literally try and console myself with the fact that we don't want to win the FA Cup. Stand him up, don't want to do anything silly. You know, like concede a third. That's what we're all about. We've said we never conceded 3 goals this season. There it goes. Oh, no. Apparently the flag is up. New gen bit was a bit poor. Preferred the old gen, but they patched the new gen, which made it much better. Okay. I mean, I've not played FIFA for a few years, so none of that really makes much sense to me. But okay. Do you know what I mean? Like, that. Yeah, okay. That's fine. I don't know. The new gens and the old gens and the other gens, they all need to work better. Got you. Simon Tipple, I'm sorry. Right, you know what? This is what we're going to do. We're going to make 3 changes at half time. Going for it. All for it. Which means we've got nothing else in the second half before he puts it in. And there's Hargreaves on his debut. 55 seconds he's been on the pitch. And he's got himself a goal. Seen a couple of streamers play the new FIFA. It looks pretty good. The graphics look great. Yeah, I think graphically it does look excellent, doesn't it? Especially if you're playing like on the PS5 or the Xbox Series X, is it? I think. Then yeah, it certainly does look the part. FIFA doesn't appeal to me personally, but this is a man who finds solace in virtual spreadsheets. I'm kind of with you, Keg, to be honest. Like, I don't really feel as though there's anything for me in FIFA. Because I'm not fussed with it. Like, you know, I don't play as big teams when I'm here, so there's not really anything like playing sort of as Oldham, for example, on FIFA online. That's just grim, isn't it? Like, nobody needs that. And plus, I'm not bothered about Ultimate Team either. Like, I hate that idea. Oh, Adam Ida. Yeah. Yeah, like, I hate Ultimate Team. It's fine for Madden, because it sort of makes sense, because fantasy football's a little bit more like that. For fantasy NFL, like, I sort of get it. And then the sort of the online thing with UFC as well, where it sort of allowed you to sort of, like, get certain moves for your fighter. Again, that made sense, but for FIFA, I can't really understand why people would do it, and I certainly don't get that people would pay for it. You know what I mean? Like, no, certainly don't get that at all. Fantasy NFL, I get. So the thing with Fantasy Premier League, Inky, is for Fantasy NFL, is that they're all proper drafts so that nobody can have the same players, whereas Fantasy Premier League, most of the time, Ewan's with a goal there. Most of the time, it's players who've all got exactly the same people, so it's like just a bit. I hate the idea of having to have the same players to get your points in FPL. I know there are a few fantasy leagues that are draft based, And they're much better, because again, it's that whole sort of like, you can have the one player who's getting the points, but if you haven't got them, then you have to make up the points somewhere else and try and trade for like players and picking up players in the waiver wire and stuff like that. That's, for me, is there's more skill involved there. I don't like the other FPL of, right, let's all have Haaland, let's all have De Bruyne, let's all have Salah or whatever, like, you know, which has been the few years, and then having to sort of work out who a triple captain and all that nonsense. Like, nah, not for me personally. You know, some people obviously are all for it, but not for me. Raggio, don't quite know how I'm winning my NFL fantasy league. You think you've miscalculated somewhere, mate? The thing that the NFL season has just started in bizarre fashion. So to be fair, it probably makes no sense for anybody really as to where the points are going. But if you're top of the league, that probably makes sense, to be honest. My man Trek, how are you, buddy? Welcome. Now Trek is not. I'm going to shout Trek out now, right? And it's going to give you a link to Trek right here. But it's not going to make any sense because he tends to stream over on YouTube. So what we're going to say is, I'm going to pull it up as well here. We're going to give him his YouTube links. So make sure you drop a link and a follow over on Trek over on YouTube, because we love him. He's a wonderful human being, and I think you're going to enjoy him as well. So give him some love over there. How are you, brother? Are you well? Nice to see you in here, to be honest. Chilling on the evening. Saw your new setup as well. Looks very, very swanky. Very, very jealous of that. Yeah, obviously gutted we didn't get the football this weekend, but we'll get some sorted out later on. So you just put the heating on. Oh dear, Inky's complaining there about having no money, and he's put the heating on. Oh, Billy Baller over here, you know, it's flashing the cash. Someone's won the lottery. But yeah, here we are. We're getting towards, as I said, towards the business end of the championship. Trek, what's your situation for for FM23? Because we sort of spoke about it fairly briefly, didn't you? Because you were sort of like nudging potentially into the old British Steel Challenge as well. So I don't know if you decided against it and went for something else, or whether you've decided to stick with another plan or not. But yeah, it's nice to have you in, as I say. Evening RC, how are you? We're all very, very well. We're all very well indeed. Thank you very much. Certainly can't complain. Life's good. Everyone's well. No one's got COVID today. We don't think, anyway, but, you know, seems fine. Norwich versus Ipswich. Get in. East Anglian clash. Local derby in the cup. Get in. This is what we're talking about. This is what this save's all about, isn't it? Narrative. We went 2-0 down against Middlesbrough. Yes, go ahead, Eagles. Loving that. I think I did see you say about go ahead, Eagles. Thing is, there's that many people posting that much stuff at the minute that it's just sort of like trying to sort of remember exactly who's doing what, you know, because there is definitely quite a bit going on. Ivku, appreciate the follow. Mr. Gronk as well, appreciating the follow there. Dropped in, apologies if I didn't say that earlier on, but welcome to you. As Evan Ferguson's in, I think that's all of our transfer budget pretty much spent. This is all money that we've raised from the sale of one of our youngsters who's just come through the system. 26 million we got for him. Sorry, 46 million I should say. Sorry, 46. I mean, don't get me wrong, I'd rather we kept him, but I can see why he was sold. The club were like, he's going. And we're like, all right, fair enough. Fair enough. It was nice to have him, but he's gone. British Steel for FM24. Yeah, love it. I think this might be my new thing, Trek. Like, I'm already hating the idea of doing it. I've gone a bit too. I've got fully into it, and I'm like, right, this is going to be my thing, and I know it's going to be awful. I know it's going to be horrendous. But I was literally flicking up the idea of trying to do 40 years I reckon 39 trophies in 40 years. I think if we can do it in 50, I'll be very happy, but that's a lot of stream in 50 years. You know, some seasons you could maybe get a double, and that's gonna help you out. But it's gonna depend as well on picking the right team, isn't it? You know, and that's a little bit too. That's the bit that I'm gonna struggle with. That being like laser focused on the specific teams. Whereas for me, I'm just like, we'll just go wherever, you know. And it'll be fun. We'll end up with like four seasons at, you know, banger, struggling to get promoted and be like, this is great. And just forgetting that I've still got 39 trophies to win. you start unemployed. Yeah, of course I'm starting unemployed. Unemployed, no badges. I think the game will probably send us to Northern Ireland first, I would imagine. We'll end up in Northern Ireland or Wales. First of all, because they're the lowest ranked leagues, I would imagine. So second division in Wales or second division in Northern Ireland, and it's gonna be fucking grim. It's gonna be so grim there. I genuinely think it's gonna be like, I mean, imagine just how sad you're gonna feel trying to get through those leagues. So you've got to win everything in the UK, so every trophy in England, so that's the Vanarama National North and National South, then the Vanarama National, then of course League One, League Two, Championship, Premiership, Johnston's Paints, FA Cup, League Cup, Vanarama National Trophy or whatever, Northern Irish Tesco's Cup or whatever they've got. As Trek says, it's the perfect advert. This is going to be so fucking grim. But think of all the fun we're going to have with the stories we're going to tell. This is what it's going to be. Like, it's going to take me 100 years in real life, Inky. This is the thing. I'm okay with the fact that we might not do it, because that's part of the fun, isn't it? Part of the fun is not actually doing it. We can go in and be like, yeah, we're going to try and get this done. But if we don't do it, we don't do it. It's not a problem. It can be our new thing. We'll try this every year. So you've got people like Second Yellow Card, who does a build a nation every year. This can be our thing. Every year we'll be like, remember? Right, last year we won 3 trophies. How many can we do this year? I don't think they do have Tesco's. I'll see. To be honest, I panicked a little bit. I can bring out some of the. This is some of the names of the cups that we've got to try and work with here. Okay. What have we got here? So, in Northern Ireland, there's the Danske Bank Premiership, the Bluefin Sport Championship, the Bluefin Sport Premier Intermediate League. So there's 3 leagues to win. The Northern Irish Cup, the League Cup, the County Antrim Shield, the Steel and Sons Cup, the Intermediate Cup, and the Mid-Ulster Cup. So there's 9 trophies in Northern Ireland alone. Czar 74, welcome, appreciate the follow, very kind for you to be here. We're going to have a spreadsheet, RC, don't worry about that, although it's going to be a very short spreadsheet of 0 trophies, 0. That'll be interesting because not every team plays in every cup. Oh, Richard, don't, no, I've not even considered that possibility. Goal, own goal as well. So if you play the County Antrim Cup, you aren't in the Mid-Ulster Cup. Oh, I've not considered this. Oh, this is brilliant. This is absolutely brilliant. This is going to be so much fun. We're going to have to leave just to get into... We're going to have to leave a club just to get into a regional Irish cup. Oh, God. Oh, dear. And technically that means that we might have to throw the league just to focus on the cup. Oh, I feel sad. At least in Wales it's easy. Wales Premier League, Welsh Cup, Nathaniel MG Cup. But we'll stick Welsh League 2 in there as well, because, you know, why not? The Republic of Ireland have got the Premier Division, the First Division, the Senior Challenge Cup, the League Cup, the Munster Cup, the Leinster Senior Cup, and the President's Cup. Again, not 100% sure whether they're regional or not. Go from Northern Ireland to Wales, back to Ireland, to Scotland, to England. Yeah, I think it's. I think that's the way to do it, I reckon. Sorry, Keg, do you want to ping me that link and I'll have a quick look at it, because we don't have the links on bounce back on the chat. Or if you want to send it to Raju, he can sort you out on that. The cup's possibly changed a wee bit. Is that what you're thinking, that they've changed their title? Scotland's fairly straightforward. Premiership, Championship, League One, League Two, Scottish Cup, and then what, a Premier Sports Cup maybe, and SPFL Trust Trophy. So that'll be fine. Knowing Northern Irish football, I watched every week for 5 years. You having to go to a club just to win the Ulster Mid Cup is very funny. Is it? I've got a feeling this is going to be a really silly save. But this is what it's all about, though. Like, this is what I want out of Football Manager. You know what I mean? Like, I don't want this sort of. I don't want to be like, oh, you know what's great? You know, winning the Champions League with, you know, Real Madrid. Yeah, I think this is the one that we started working off. This is the one, isn't it? Yeah, 2019 thread. Yeah. So this is it. It's 38 trophies apparently. I'm sure there's 39 now, maybe. So, that's it. Yeah. So the First Division promotion counts, and the Leicester. Oh, no. Sorry, this is someone else's thing, isn't it? I'm busy reading it out now. Yeah, that's all the cups. I'm going to put this out here, right? Can I copy and paste all this here into the chat for you? So we don't have to. So basically, it reaches the character limit. So we don't have to win the playoffs. All we have to do is. So you can win the playoffs instead of winning the league. So, for example, we're in the Championship right now. If we finish second and we get promoted, that's fine. That counts as winning. That counts as that as the trophy for the Championship. Yeah. If we win, if we get promoted by the playoffs, that counts as winning the Championship. So again, that counts as our trophy. We don't have to win the playoffs and then go back to be like, oh shit, we go back down and actually win the league. But you're right, Keg. The chat is probably going to make me want to win both the league and the playoffs. There's going to be a thing in it. We're going to get to the playoff final and the chat's going to be sat there going, nope, throw the match. We don't get promoted like this. Yeah, I love the fact you already know what my chat are like, Keg. This is exactly what they'll be like. They'll be going, there's no purity in winning it this way. We have to be champions or nothing. Apologies, I've just punched my microphone at that point there, didn't I? So 10 years in Northern Ireland, then 17 years in the Republic. Evening, Zims. How are you, buddy? Welcome to a man who's one of my favourite streamers right now. And he's going to smash up the playoffs this weekend. Go and drop Zims Mueller a follow, everybody, please. Give that man some love. Czar, since when is the playoffs a title? In this challenge, is Czar. Basically, the challenge is that you have to win every trophy that's available within all of the UK. So things like, just basically because you're moving up a league, so the challenge is too difficult itself anyway. But to say, well, you have to only win the title, like imagine winning the playoffs, then having to go back down and re-win that league to classify as a trophy. If you're doing it as an achievement hunter and a trophy hunter, then yes, you would go and do that. But the challenge that is set out here is just to literally get promoted. A title is when you lift a trophy. Yeah, True, but I mean, I didn't make the challenge up, so you know, I can't really be held ultimately accountable for this. But I get you, though. I get you. Are you bending the rules here? It seems like it, doesn't it? It seems like it, Trek. I'm being like, I've got the Hague here taking me up and going, I think you'll find you've said trophies. So therefore you are gonna go back, right? And you're gonna win those titles, or you're a fraud. You know what? Fuck it, we'll do that then. We'll not do that. We're not doing that. I've said something I can't take back now, haven't I? let's chat with Zims. How are you getting on, buddy? Yeah, like I say, can't wait to see you in the playoffs this weekend, man. It's going to be awesome. Genuinely looking forward to it. If this is the thing, if we have to do it, if it has to be, right, win everything, then, all right, fine. You spend a whole year in FM in Northern Ireland. Yeah, probably. Probably. If that's to the absolute definition that you wish to play the game, then yes, you would spend probably most of the year in Northern Ireland. Yeah. But the joy of this game is that some challenges, and this is a well-known challenge, some challenges aren't that specific about it. You found Zims today, RC? You know what, Zim? Like, RC, first time I found Zims, I was over the moon. I was like, this guy I like. And he was on my radar for the playoffs. I was like, we need to get this guy. We need to have a look at him. And you know, thankfully, the more people that watch, the more people just like, yes, this guy's going to come in. And then he turns up and he smashes the path to the playoffs. And we're all sat there just like rubbing our hands, just going, yeah, this guy, this is the guy. It's all about getting the right time in it, Zims. Get the right time. You know, Land Shutter, hello, I'm still the best manager in the world. Cool. Good. I'll be honest, Land Shutter, I am just about, at the minute, just about the best manager in East Anglia on this game. So, you know. We're getting there. Making you blush, mate. Don't worry about it. You know you're good. You know you're good. It's gonna be fun this weekend, man. The world versus the East of England. Yeah. I mean, to be fair, I would say that you've probably got a better team if you're picking from the world. Although I've got Adam Ida, so you know, swings and roundabouts, isn't it? Yeah, it's going to be great. It's going to be great. If you haven't already followed the FM Playoffs, by the way, everybody, drop a follow on the Playoffs channel. FM Playoffs this weekend, RC. So, similar to the Streamer Showdown. Again, it's a streamer competition, or creator competition, we should say, sorry. I'll be hosting. We've got a cracking panel, which we can't announce yet, but they are very, very good. As we say, the actual contestants that are going to be battling it out. Let's go through them for you, so you can see who's on tonight, who's on this weekend. Sorry, it's a stacked. The cards are always stacked, but this is so. Zims is on. Zims Mueller's on in his debut season, rookie year. AJ NRK is in as part of his debut. These two both won their groups in the path to the playoffs, so that's incredible. For the first time of doing it, right? Then Grimmy's in again. He's making his playoffs debut. Wickdiv is in, McKinns is in, the Mad Scientist is in, Ali's in, FM Girl is in, Tim Lewis is in, the current reigning champion Hood Gaming is in, and because it's the last one of the season of FM22, Work the Space and Lelujo. Kevy seven times makes his FM playoffs debut. I think it's going to be pretty decent, to be honest. So it's top. So we've got eight teams in there, now 12 teams in there. It's going to be the top one goes through, best place, second place goes through as well. So you've got, I'm sure it's top two, no, three. I'm trying to do maths here. 12. So it'll be two groups of six. Two will go through, three possibly. I need to work out the maths, but yeah, yeah, it's that's right. Yeah, it's Saint Grimmy. Saint Grimmy is his username, so I think it's that, isn't it? Do I need a hand, TJ? Yeah, Keg. What's the rules? Explain to me the rules. Tell me how many teams go through. I don't need to know this information. I just sit behind a desk, looking grey. But yeah, if you win your group, you get a bye, I believe. So you miss out the quarters, you go straight to the semis. That's where my maths bit doesn't work. So even Bulby, how are you? A lot of different streamers. Yeah. So we've kind of got our own crew of streamers, really. We've got sort of like what we would class as like a playoff set. And then, yeah, we've managed to get some guys in from the showdown. So we're very, very excited. And yeah, I think it's gonna be a great competition. Really, really looking forward to it. And I think that it's gonna be a lot of fun. Unless things have changed up my knowledge, top three from each group went to the quarters, top of the group gets the bye of the semis. That's what I was trying to work out. As I say, it's all down to, you know, counting. And counting's not quite my thing. Yeah. Taking that much of a backseat, I'm currently in the boot. Mate, I'm in a trailer. Just about, I'm in the caravan that's been left behind at the caravan site. I'm going, we were going to tow it back, but we figured we'd just leave it. That's where I am at the minute. Yeah, I came in with some good ideas, and everyone just went, enough of you now. You just sit there. Okay. But yeah, I think it's going to be pretty good. It's going to be pretty, pretty good. So yeah, that's so the draft is Thursday. Draft is Thursday. So it's come and join us and watch that. And then the drafts and crafts is on the Friday, which is me and the panel just having a few beers, chatting how over the draft went and making our predictions for the weekend. And then of course the main event is Sunday, which is gonna be a lot of fun from 7 o'clock, I believe so. Yeah, definitely worth keeping your eyes peeled. Adam Ida should have scored that. Did the Google form yesterday to get in the playoffs, path to the playoffs during FM23. I know you did, Trek. I know you did. Again, there was a conversation that was happening yesterday about yourself as well, prior to actually sending in a form. We're trying to sort of go, you know, remember Trek was out. Trek used to, when we were trying to work out when you did it last. So, yeah, and then you ping the form through, and it's just like, ah, okay. Oh, Adam Ida. I mean, to be honest, Trek, they were saying horrible things. I was sticking up for you. Mate, I was sticking up. Them lot. The other ones, oh. I'm not disputing it wasn't all true, but I'm just saying what they said was disgusting. Yeah, you've got a long stream on Sunday, Zims. Long stream, because you'll be streaming from like about lunchtime probably anyway, doing your normal save. Then you'll go straight into the playoffs. And then, you know, if you're going to be there at the final, you're going to be there till probably about 11:30, I would say. So bring snacks. PMs, Man United, Newcastle, then Liverpool, then City, then the playoffs. Yeah, that is. Yeah, there's. We, to be fair, we've not really scheduled it well, have we, with them, with other things that have been going on. So there's definitely quite a bit happening on Sunday, but life goes on. I'm ready. That's the spirit. United win, City and Liverpool and City both gonna lose. That's gonna be, I mean, that is gonna be quite a performance, RC, if both City and Liverpool lose against each other. I mean, that is I'll be honest, I don't like Liverpool either, but even I think it's going to be impossible for them to lose and for City to also lose. I mean, to be fair, I did the calculations actually recently, and this was today, and I've been slagging Steven Gerrard off for a year, right? For a year, saying he's a terrible manager, he's the wrong manager for Villa. There's no way that Villa should have had him. What an absolutely disgraceful appointment it was. And now I've looked at the league table, and Villa are only a point behind Liverpool, so maybe Gerrard's actually a genius. I mean, of course he's not. He's not. He's shit, right? He's absolutely shit, and he deserves to be sacked. He's worse than Tim Sherwood. Literally, he's now mathematically worse than Tim Sherwood. How that fraud still has a job, I've got no idea. At all. Oh, don't worry, Zims. It was the old pull back and reveal, wasn't it? It was also then a joke at how bad Liverpool are doing as well. His old assistant is doing very well. Yeah, QPR, Beal. Yeah, apparently he was the so-called brains of the operation up at Rangers, and yeah, he's definitely. I mean, to be fair, he wasn't much help when he was at Villa, but he's certainly gone and done well over at QPR. Newcastle fans were right about Steve Bruce all along. Everyone was right about Steve Bruce. Everyone was right about Steve Bruce. Steve Bruce is a dreadful manager, but let's be honest, it's a. We're not talking Newcastle. I'm not bringing myself to it. I'm not bringing myself to it. Fuck Newcastle. Like, Shakhtar about to beat Real Madrid. Did they beat Real Madrid recently as well? Like, did they beat them last week as well? What am I thinking? It was Sheriff that beat them last year, wasn't it? I think Sheriff beat them last season. Juve lost as well today, didn't they? Juve lost to Maccabi Haifa, I think. Get Ole at Villa. No, Ole is... Solskjaer's a terrible manager at Villa. Tell you what Villa need. Villa desperately need Sean Dyche, and that's it. Like, nobody else. Just Sean Dyche. No questions asked. Like, no backup plan. Just, that's it. You know, and if they don't get Sean Dyche, then I'll say, get Big Sam. Get Big Sam. You know, Pep to get bored, leave City. Sean Dyche steps in at City, 4-4-2s. Could you imagine? Could you imagine? He'd love it, wouldn't he? Get the ball up in the air to Haaland. Get Marcelino in. Got Valencia to fourth twice. Well, that's the thing, though, actually. I think if he's got Valencia to fourth, I can't see him stepping down to a relegation-threatened club at Aston Villa. You know, you've got to be looking for a... This is the problem. You've got to look for realistic managers, you know? And I think the realistic managers are Sean Dyche and Big Sam and possibly even Brendan Rodgers. Just do like a relegation swap with Leicester. Just go, right, we'll take Brendan Rodgers off you and you can have Gerrard or Benitez. Rafa de Villa? I don't think Rafa's bothered, to be honest. I think he's made enough money elsewhere that he doesn't have to do it, so I can't really see him coming in now. I certainly can't see Pochettino. I think Pochettino's far too high profile. So yeah, but then again, I can also see Villa not sacking Gerrard, and Perslow will be sat there going, oh no, you know, me Bezzy has to stay, because you know, it's a vanity project for him, so I can see that still being the situation. Eventually, though, you have to look at the numbers and be like, that's not a thing. That's not good enough, is it, really? Poch to Leicester? Poch to England, maybe. Poch to England, I could maybe see. outside of France, what's Pochettino won? Well, yeah, there is that. But this is the thing, like, there's only so many managers that are going to win something anyway, though. There's not many, well, you know, there's not that many titles. I know we've just been debating there. There's 39 to win throughout the countries, but there's not a lot of titles to win, you know? And there's only a certain amount of managers that will win anything. So, I don't know, putting things on winning's not really a massive sort of like indicator of success, because again, you'll then put, like, you'll see some managers that have won stuff, you'd be like, how the hell have they won something? Like, you know, like Steve McClaren won a League Cup with Middlesbrough. Like, it doesn't really mean that Steve McClaren was a good manager. Spurs should have won the league the year Leicester won the league. Like, that was the year for Spurs to win. That wasn't a title that Leicester won. That's not to take away what Leicester did, of course. It's not to take away what Leicester did. That was Tottenham's title to lose, and they lost it. You know, they ran out of steam towards the end of the season, and when Leicester just kept winning, it should have been there for Tottenham to win. And then when they just kept dropping points. So you're right, like, how do you get that winning mentality in those players? That's the question. But you've also got to think as well, if he's coming to a team, for example, like a Villa, he's not going to have the same sort of players out at Tottenham or Paris Saint-Germain. He's going to have the same sort of players out at Southampton. So it's like remembering to go back to his roots to be like, right, how do I get a tune out of poor players? You know, and to be fair, same with England. Like, if it goes to England, it's not, you know, it's just about how do you manage, like, sort of 6 games a year, which I guess you could technically argue was Paris Saint-Germain. The rest of it just sort of picks itself, and you just work on the Champions League games, really. That'll do, Ryan Ewins. To think we were going to cut his loan spell short. I mean, Serena Wiegmann would be incredible as a manager any men's team. Same as Emma Hayes. But we all know that football fans can't be trusted to have female managers. So, especially after we saw all the nonsense over the weekend as well with Casillas. So, which is a shame. Football needs a big culture change. Yeah, agreed. Like, I think, I did this in my show and I can't remember who the team was. There was a team in Italy, hired a female manager for a little bit. And it was literally like a couple of days and that was it. I think a team in France, I'm sure it was Clermont Foot, did the same thing as well. But, yeah. Yeah, France. Yeah, Clermont. I'm sure it was Clermont Foot, wasn't it? And I think the manager they got in, she was really highly rated at the time as well. Scouting in Germany, is she? Oh, that's cool. Well, I'm glad she's still involved in football. I'm sure she came from Celtic or something, maybe. I think that rings a bell. But yeah, it's a tricky one, isn't it? Like, you know, there's female coaches in the NFL. Costa, maybe, yeah. Could be. Yeah, I'm sure she came from. Let's have a look. Was it? The skin we're using is the Renzi dark skin. There you go. That's the skin over there. We've also had a look at the Tato skin as well, which is, again, it's quite a nice one. Have to sit and wait for our new skins as well, aren't we? For FM23, 95th minute equaliser for Real Madrid. Oh dear. Unbelievable, right? Yeah. 95th minute, has to be, doesn't it? Has to be. Just keep playing till they score. Keep playing till they score. No, I don't know. There was always meant to be 90. There was always meant to be 96 minutes on always. There must have been. I'm sure it was in France. Helena Costa. That's what she was called. Claire Monchfort. There you go. Yeah, I was right. I was right with that. The Italy bit I was wrong with, but yeah. And this was back in 2014. Yeah, one of the best qualified coaches in the game. Master's degree in sports science, UEFA A license. Also started a PhD in sports and PE in Lisbon. Brilliant. But yeah, just didn't go anywhere, unfortunately. Manager of the month, excellent, thank you very much. Yeah, if you're wondering why we're just firing through this, because we are basically trying to get this game finished, of course, before FM23, so we need to get this season done either tonight or tomorrow night, then we go for the playoffs for the rest of the week. Then that means next week should be season 10. Fingers crossed, the Premier League. And then we're probably into either beta territory or a week off just before beta starts. So either or. And the Rudiger injury. Oh, what happened to Rudiger? Yeah. Season 10 will definitely be the last season. I'll see. So the last season of FM23, then of course will be. Of FM22, I should say, sorry. Beer is on the 25th, apparently. Oh, okay. On 24th. That would make sense. Yeah. That would give us probably a couple of weeks-ish. No, if that's a ballpark time, that sort of is fairly understandable. Cambrodia, welcome in. Welcome. Do you reckon it'll be the Friday cake? The thing with Fridays is, of course, is if there's anything wrong, then no one can answer. I'm sure it always used to be a Monday or Tuesday. I think it was a Thursday once, wasn't it? Evening, Cambrodia. Very well, thank you. Very well. How was your stream, man? I just dropped you a wee shower in there as well, so... Yeah, see, I get that bit. It's a weekend to work with it, but I thought it was always the whole, like, everyone kicks off and it's that whole social media can't respond to, why does this not work? Why does this not work? But, yeah, it'll be in or around the last week of October. I would imagine that sounds about right. Yeah, no worries, man. Appreciate raiding and running. Not a trouble at all. You can take it easy, man. We'll see you soon. I may be able to put a schedule together for FM23. Yeah, okay. What are we looking at? I saw the whiteboard out earlier. Ferguson should have finished that. Can't wait to report the same bugs I reported this year and last year and the year before. Well. I think we've got to work out what's a bug and what's a gripe, isn't it? And I'm not particularly versed at spotting either, to be honest. I spotted a couple where there's like sort of the text doesn't quite fit or whatever. That's the only things I can see. And even then I'm like, how have I managed to spot them? See, plan, you're right. Plan is one thing. Sticking to it. Implementation is a different, isn't it? Oh, Sar, should have scored that. It's not sure if I'm doing Twitch or YouTube. It's a decision to be made, isn't there, Keg? Trek obviously knows the lay of the land over at over on YouTube, and I guess, you know, there's people like Trek doing a good job over there, Hood's doing a good job over there. No, there's definitely I know there's definitely been some glances from a few people going like, is YouTube the way to go? Good save. Just had nosy. What's Defog? Oh, Defog's the that's a hell of a challenge as well, isn't it? I need to pull that back up as well. Is that JM coming in? Hello, JM. Welcome. Hope you're well. Big shout for JM. There's a goal for Watford, unfortunately. Never mind. Scono, new here. What's the goal and saves beside to get Norwich promoted? So the save, Scono, is nothing to do with Norwich at all, to be honest. The save here is what we call the Story Hunter. Now, it's a little bit like a lot of streamers tend to rate themselves on success. Kimmy Minx, hello Kimmy, how are you? Long time since we've seen you around, hope you're well. Welcome in. Pleasure to see you, nice to see you back in the community again. Hope life's treating going well in your world. And the thing with Norwich, as I say, the thing with Norwich is basically, right, everyone likes to win stuff. I'm not that good at winning. I'm good at telling stories and getting myself into all the sorts of like scrapes and stuff and being like, oh, that was good. Remember the time that we bottled this? Or can't believe we've managed to sort of like pick ourselves up from relegation and get promoted. That's how we're running this save here. So we've done it for about 9 years so far. Next season is going to be the last season because, of course, FM23 is coming out. We started unemployed. We ended up at Brackley for 4 years. Then we went to York City. We got back-to-back promotions from the National League North to the National League, then into the Football League. We then jumped ship up to Bolton. We did well at Bolton. Then we got the job at Norwich, who were actually beneath Bolton at the time. But we've managed to pull Norwich right up from the bottom of the Championship all the way up to what is now currently first or second, looking to get into the Premier League next season. So that's sort of how the save's gone, to be honest. But yeah, but it's a pleasure having you in. Hope you're well. Kimmy feeling like a bit of a stranger. Don't worry about that. You're back, though. That's the main thing. You know what I mean? You're back. Getting your crafts on. Or will we see you back on FM next year? Because I think you've been missed, haven't you? Yeah. It's a story of mutiny from a fella called Williams. Yeah, that's pretty much it, Lulu. That's sort of where we are, isn't it? Or is that the Defog description? Yeah, Defog is, Keg's described it there. Simmer season, take over the lowest rep team, then gets promoted into the tier six. That's right. Yeah, you have to get the essentially a grayed out team, really, isn't it? Take them and go as far as you can. You'll be back. Excellent. Glad to hear it. Missing angry swearing streams. Martin Allen with a goal. Come on. Norwich, what are we doing here? Oh yeah, I mean yeah. You've not had the best of years, Kimmy. Don't worry. I think we can forgive you for not streaming. You know what I mean? Being like, well, to be honest, I mean, I know everything's going on, but you know, come on, streaming. No, it'd be a bit unfair for people to think that, to be honest. Okay, it'd be just, editing down highlights. Sign a player must be able to scout them. That doesn't mean you have to just have accessible scouts. Oh, of course, yeah. Describing the whole situation with Defog. Yeah, so there's no. So you can't just use the player search screen. You can't just like instantly go, oh, right, he's got like good attributes. Let's go and jump on there. any strain. Can't do that. You've got to properly scout and properly. Essentially, you're trying to make it as realistic as you possibly can. So the same with staff as well. You have to put job adverts out. So it's similar to what we do. Yeah, you might have to ping it direct to Trek Keg because links and that in it. Second time we've fallen foul of that, I'm afraid. So Kimmy, the save's going pretty well. Thank you. We're having a lovely time. We've had some interesting parts of the save, to be honest. And then this is sort of the bit. This is going to be our fourth defeat of the season now, which means we dropped back to second, which is a shame. And it's the first time we've actually lost more than 1-0 as well. So all three defeats have come with a 1-0 defeat. Caffeine's in. Welcome, Caffeine. Appreciate seeing you here. We've not seen you for a while. How are you getting on? I saw you tweeting the other day, actually. You weren't in a particularly good space, but hope life's treating you better. And with a tier one as well. 7 months, my man. Appreciate you. Lovely to see you in. Evening Apocalypse as well. How the devil are you? We're all grand over here, buddy. Had a lovely weekend. How was Edinburgh? Did you enjoy Extreme Rules? There you go. Look at them logos there. Look at them. There's the TGFMs in. There we go. Let's have a few more of them, shall we? Just click through. Just click through. We've not got time to sit and, you know, do a sort of debrief on where that went wrong. We've got to go straight now to fourth round of the FA Cup against Norwich. Against Ipswich, sorry. So it's a local derby here. Caffeine's still not great. Kidney issues. We're still on this side of the ground. And it's getting taken care of. That's good. That's good. The fact that it's there's some element of positivity there. That's the main thing, right? Are they going 5 men across the midfield to try and nullify this? This is like... Okay, we're only going 4-4-2. Don't go 5 across the midfield. Like... It's fine. We can do that. They're obviously worried about us. Edinburgh's beautiful as always. Yeah, Edinburgh's a stunning city. Stunning city. Look at this lad. The next Hakan Şükür. Oh, look at him. 18 years old. 17 for first touch. 19 determination. 16 for jumping reach. Yeah, let's keep our eyes on him. Yeah, we could be. Yeah, we quite like that guy. Tuesday, Saturday, followed by Extreme Rules at the bar. Didn't sleep a week before church. Yeah, it was good though, right? It was good. I've watched most of it. There's two bits I fell asleep. I fell asleep twice at the Drew McIntyre and Karrion Kross match. I was just like, oh, I can't be arsed with this. But I've gone back to watch the rest of it. It's pretty good, to be honest. It's pretty good. And yeah, the Bray Wyatt return was done really nicely. Really nicely indeed. Anyway, tips for bad whiplash? No. I can't say I have. The closest I've come to that was I fell off a rig once in the gym. Came off and landed on my back and properly hurt really badly. Like, literally came off the pull-up bar, landed flat on in the middle of the gym. Everyone saw it. Very embarrassing. Painkillers aren't helping. Have you tried? I mean, like, I guess it depends upon what level of painkillers you've got as well, isn't it? If you've got like the strongest ones, then yeah, that's gonna be. I don't know what the next step up is, to be honest. Whiskey Tramadol, that'll be the one. That'll be the one. Yeah, Trek, appreciate you being in, buddy. Always. Much love to you. We'll catch you soon. As I say, we'll see you in a wee bit, buddy. Appreciate you stopping by. Right, so Ipswich in the fourth round, then Huddersfield, Millwall, Coventry, Ipswich again, West Brom, Bristol, Bournemouth, Birmingham, Forest, Bolton, Sunderland, Palace. So that's the run-in. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12 matches to go. Are we going to get them done tonight? It's going to be tight. It's going to be tight getting it done tonight. Might spill over into tomorrow night, folks. Maybe. Maybe. We'll see. If it does spill into tomorrow night, then we can finish the season whilst discussing episode 1 of the Football Manager Show by The Athletic. That comes out tomorrow. Very, 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 very excited about that. Very excited. Everyone's been very pleasant about it so far. People have been really nice. Comments have been good. Just waiting to get episode 1 done now. Get it done. Put it out into the ether. Then everyone can be like, okay, there you go. That's the thing. Sound surprised, AJ, and he'd been pleasant to even up. I mean, to be fair, I was expecting an unpleasant comment or two, Keg, and either my filters have been doing well and it's blocking them, or people haven't quite got around to watching it yet. So either way is fine by me, you know. Yeah, there's I've seen a couple of nice comments to be in there, which is like, no idea who this, I didn't actually know about this Tony guy, but I quite like his vibe. I'm like, I'll take that. And I have one comment today from someone who's been catching up on Football Manager therapy, and he tweeted me today and went, holy shit, you're the guy who did Football Manager ruin my life. I was like, yeah. That was it. Yep, I think it's in the show description. But yeah, but no, and you know what? Everyone's been really lovely about FMT as well, and we like that. There you go. Get yourself subscribed to FMT. It's not out tomorrow. It's not out today. It should be today, actually. It's out the 25th, I believe. That's the. Oh, is he offside? Oh, good save. Come on, we need Ferguson to get his first goal. Come on. Local derbies and cup matches, man. Like, it's too stressful, right? I'm not even a fan of Norwich or Ipswich, and I'm on tenterhooks here. I know we said we weren't fussed about the cup, but local pride at stake here. Nicely cleared. I would have felt more comfortable if Adam Ida was playing. And we know there's definitely a goal in us. Oh, that's not what we wanted. No, sirree. How come Barr's been outjumped? It's Baptiste. Thompson Brown switched off. The way you're talking, like, the way you're talking sounds like you aren't managing it. I mean, Eder, is it Adam Eder, is it? I would have gone with Eder, but if I'm wrong, then I'm wrong. And I'm happy to be wrong. And you know me, JM. I'm always surprised. I'm always surprised. Oh, you got in the neck, did you? Ah, okay. Well, that is Adam Eder then. When's the next FMS pod come out? Tomorrow, JM. I think we're going to get knocked out of the FA Cup here, everybody. Yeah, gone. Knocked out by our local rivals. Ooh. Not good. Not good enough, that. Although technically it means we've got less games to play now, so that's fine. Reckon we'll have a call-up with the T4 guys. Hey, that would be some, wouldn't it? Keg, well done. Well done. Yeah, I forgot I'd said I was the best manager in East Anglia. Oh dear, oh dear. Yeah, when things you say come back to haunt you. At least I didn't say I was the best manager in the world, right? There is that, right? As for James' question, I don't know. Maybe. I mean, if the offer came up to call up with the T4 guys, 100% we'd take it, right? I would be ripping their arms off, and then they would regret asking me to do it. Probably. Maybe. I don't know. It'd be fun. They seem like a good bunch, right? I think RDF's done stuff with them in the past before, so maybe that's how we're in. Plus we're network buddies now, so maybe if they like the cut of my jib, then we can make something happen. Oh, Apocalypse in with a sub. Yes, Apocalypse. Appreciate that. Thank you for the resub. Should make it a big sign. I'm happy to make a big sign. What's his face? The head of audio, I think, Athletic. Is he their boss? He is. He is their boss as well, Mr. McIntosh. He could make it happen. He could be like, he could just put me in there. Be like, right, you've got Jameson now. And they'll be going, why? Because. It's because I've decided. That's how we're going to do it. Diogo PNT. Appreciate the follow as well, by the way. Very kind of you. You obviously snuck in while I was embarrassing myself. I mean, not that you could narrow down as to what point they saved in the stream that would be, but the answer is it's most of it. But yeah, no, I think that would be cool. I think it'd be really cool. I feel as though you're lacking some context, Apocalypse. Oh, what form of Beth Phoenix or Rhea Ripley are we getting? Don't know. Extreme Rules has already been out of it, so. Don't know. Casket match? I don't know. Barbershop brawl? I feel like Athletic treats T4 like Sega treats SI. I can't possibly comment upon anything that would be done with my current employers, so I'll keep my head down. I'm going to say nothing at all about anything ever. One-on-one mixed tag all the way and have an intergender war games. They're not going to do it, are they? There's going to be no intergender battles, is there? I see, imagine media training. Well, yes, quite, Jim. I can be diplomatic and I can back out of many questions. I see you've had your media training. That's what the teacher, they say, put the question back on the interviewer. I see you had your media training. I see you've had your media training. Yeah. Haven't we all, but in a more real sense, haven't we all had media training? Possibly. That sounds like a better answer, doesn't it? Come on, Norwich, give us something better against Huddersfield than that embarrassing performance you gave us against Ipswich. Baptiste looks like he's going to be causing himself all manner of problems there. Borges, nils damn, that's what we're talking about. That's more like it. Evening, Rob Woolhouse, how are you? Welcome. Nice to see you. Sunderland are 2-0 up. Right, so Sunderland have gone back top, have they? Oh, no, no, no. Oh, no, we're staying top. Okay. Interesting. 77 points and we're level. Great save. Boot it clear. Boot it clear. Oh, Lewis O'Brien. Gotta do better. Gotta do better defensively there, surely. You've obviously not seen Raw than Apocalypse, have you? I'm guessing. Oh, there you are. Yeah, yeah, you have. Right, let's play out the back. Come on then. Thompson Brown. Danny Shithole. Ian Shithole. I keep calling him Danny Shithole. Danny Shithole was in Indonesia. Baptiste's causing us problems, isn't he? Just dwelling on the ball a little bit too much. Allowing issues to happen. Right. I keep ticking delighted. I don't mean to tick delighted, and I keep doing it every single time. So things are great, and they're like, it's not great. I'm like, I know. I need to try and not be too hasty on the old half-time team talk. Hey lads, everything's great. It's like that gif in it when you sort of turn up. It's from Community. He turns with the pizza and the room's on fire. Yes, James Howarth comes on as a substitute. Replaces Baptiste, gets his goal. Evening, Mr. Gudger. How the devil are you, buddy? Pleasure having you in. Big shout for Dave Gudger. And of course, because Dave Gudger's in the chat, that means we have to see the Dave Gudger spinning heads. There we go. Yeah, hope life's treating you well, Mr. Gudger. You'll be very happy to know we've signed a player from West Ham. So, and I did make a big deal about it as well. You weren't even here. I even said right at the start of the stream, go back and check it on the VOD. I said, Dave Gudger will be happy about this. £8 million on a West Ham centre-back. Oh! And you know what, Dave? He's good as well. Lovely ball. We'll, of course, remember, if you haven't already pre-ordered FM23, there's a link there to get it for £32.05 as Lavery makes it 2-2. Offside. There's my bacon saved, or faking if you're a vegan. £32.05. Sega official retailer. We've teamed up with Fanatical, as most of the FM community has. And guaranteed to get it in time for the beta as well. So, ooh, that was a bit too nervy for me. Good ball. Stanton. Oh, I thought he finished that. He saw goal. He saw goal. 3 points. There we go. That's why I said everything was brilliant. See, James confirmed it. Definite legit code. 10 out of 10. Would shop again. But the good thing is, James, you can shop again if you wish to take part in more shopping than... At the minute, I've only got a code for FM, but I'm sure they'll let me have a code for something else if I ask them nicely. Presumably, I don't know. It's also worth remembering as well that it's Amazon Prime Day coming up shortly as well, isn't it? So, anyone who's a creator in the chat, definitely worth keeping your eyes peeled for some bits of tech bargains that'll be cropping up. Looks like, from what I've seen so far, it looks like the Elgato Wave 1 microphone. It's going to be about £50. This is the Wave 3, which is like superb. But yeah, the Wave 1, still a very, very good microphone. £50. So can't argue with that. Kegman, no worries at all, buddy. You take it easy, man. Pleasure having you in there. Genuinely nice to see you tonight, so thank you very, very much for that. We'll see you soon, hopefully, buddy. Yeah. JM, I'd buy another copy, but I'd rather heat my house for a couple of hours come December. Yeah, that's reasonable. That's reasonable. I don't have a code for British Gas, unfortunately, JM. That's the thing. Maybe I need to do that. That'll be the next thing, won't it? Like, content creators be like, hey, I've got a code for British Gas. I think, to be honest, I think we're all missing out on a trick there. Great. I'm gonna make a call tomorrow. Tell us more of these gadget deals. I mean, the thing is that some of it is, it's all pre-sales at the minute, Rob, but I saw Mozza tweeting out about the Elgato Wave, so that's definitely worth keeping an eye on. Cameras I've seen for like webcams, talking like sort of basic entry level stuff, like the Logitech C920 or C922 is about £50, I think, £60. And then on the Logitech Brio is 100, and that's down from, I want to say 200, but or at least 150. But if you can see a deal for the Elgato face cam, absolutely buy that. This is what we use now. We got it when it was 150, and it was supposed to be 200. But yeah, I think it's definitely worth doing. Deal on coffee beans, yes, Raz, that would be brilliant. I did put one in the Discord, didn't I, of that CH coffee machine. It was like £400, down from 600, and Mrs. J was like, you wouldn't clean it, would you? I'm like, nah, I wouldn't. No, you're right, Mrs. J, like, let's not even beat around the bush here. That's not getting cleaned, so I'm not going to buy it, because I just can't. Yeah, so that's going to sit on the shelf for a bit. We're not getting that coffee machine. Mrs. J doesn't even drink coffee, so I can't even say, like, oh yeah, but it'd be great for you as well. She has none of it, so that's not happening. But yeah, there's loads of stuff with like lights and things like that as well, so definitely worth keeping your eyes peeled for. Sea Witch Duck, appreciate the follow. Very kind. Yeah, I'd say definitely if you're relatively newer streamer, I'll be looking at things like, in fact, actually, to be honest, here's a little tiny teaser tidbit. I've suggested something to the playoffs that we put together a pack to sort of say, even in Kutch Duck, is it Kutch Duck? It seems like it should be a Welsh Kutch. I've suggested we put together a pack to sort of say, like, look, if you're going to start streaming, this is like the basic camera you need, this is the basic microphone you need, this is the basic lighting you need, and try and work out what's the best way to make that money go as far as it can. So hopefully it'll all tie in over Prime Day. So Kutch is Welsh for hug. I thought it was. There's a tiny rebel beer called Kutch. So there you go. Welcome, Hug Duck. Shall I call you Hug Duck? Yeah. Welcome in. Appreciate you being here. Appreciate the follow. Hope you're well. Yeah, I don't even know if we'd be allowed. Thing is though, Razio, is that we're getting the kitchen done. We're getting an extension put in, and we're gonna get a brand new kitchen. So realistically, a proper coffee machine would make sense, right? But at the same time, I'm probably not gonna clean it enough, am I? Even though I drink espresso, do I need a foamer? Yes, because inevitably I'll try and treat myself to work out how to do flat whites. And then the kids will want like hot chocolates and that as well. So yes, I need one of them. Yeah, I won't clean it enough. And I don't want to get one of those like Nespresso machines, because I don't want to have to be tied into coffee subscriptions. And plus, let's be honest, the pods aren't actually that good. Nice finish. wouldn't do it until after the revamp of the kitchen. The plaster dust will go everywhere. That's a good point, Razzie. Oh, that's this is why you've been given mod powers, because you got making sensible suggestions like that. Mrs. J just said no, didn't give me any other rationale other than you won't clean it. You've said it'll get bits of plaster stuck in it. So that's the bit I need. Dave Goodger, have you got code for hotels in Norwich? I haven't, but I think the Premier Inn is still cheap, although apparently the Ibis has got some decent deals on as well at the minute. Even Chicken, how are you? Welcome. JM throwing the towel in for the night. Best of luck reclaiming the best manager in the East Anglia job title. It's gone, JM. I've lost it completely. I'm an embarrassment to myself and the region of East Anglia. So, but it's a pleasure having you back in, as always. And like I said to you earlier, how's your elbow, by the way? We should have spoken about that, shouldn't we? Hope it's getting fixed. Obviously, that meant that we couldn't do football this weekend. But, oh, what a goal that is. Evan Ferguson with his first goal for the club. Beautiful stuff. Chicken, hype for FM23? You better believe. You better believe we're hype for FM23. What about yourself? What's your save plans? Get up there. What a header that is. Considering it's a broken elbow, it's quite okay, to be honest. Not ideal, but fine. Do you know what? If that's all it is, then that's good. If you can hang about with a broken elbow and be like, yeah, it's all right, you know, I've had worse, then that's a... then you're a braver man than I am. A 4, it overhits that, I think. Damn. To the back post, Jed Spence nods it back down. Should have scored, maybe? A 4? Baptiste. 1-2, didn't quite work. To be fair, that header's not quite as bad as Cameron Archer's yesterday for Villa. Brilliant defensive clearance, but a terrible header if you're a striker. Hand hurts a bit, doesn't bend properly, that's okay. Still can't use my hand to click on things on FM. Oh no, you need one of those, you know, like The Simpsons when they have the sort of the head pointer. Need that. Jem sounds like a proper old school footballer playing on broken bones. Doesn't he? Like, you remember you must have heard, I'm sure I've told this story before, the story about Stuart Pearce when he played for Man City. No, we played for West Ham. It was against Man City, and it was just before half time. He broke his leg, okay, and he walked off the pitch because he's Stuart Pearce. And in the dressing room, they're sat and they're going, "Right, Stuart, you've broken your leg." And his response was apparently, "I'll give it 5 minutes. I'll give it 5 minutes. I'll try and run it off. It's only a broken leg." How hard do you have to be to try and run off a broken leg and go, just needs, yeah, it's broken, but just like, it'll be fine as long as I don't sprint. Are we finishing the season? Hopefully, Bolby. I want to get finished by midnight. So if we're not finished by midnight, then no. But I think we'll get as close as we possibly can to finishing the season. Stuart Pearce was a machine, absolutely a machine. And you know what? But like a really good player as well, like thinking about that. Adlisiege. I think I've said that wrong. I'm really sorry if I have, Adlisiege. Appreciate the follow. Very kind. I should really try and do this phonetically, shouldn't I? Try and sort of like spell people's names. But yeah, appreciate the follow. It's very nice of you to be here. Hope you're well. We're just talking about Stuart Pearce, and we're probably going to inevitably then end up talking about Julian Dix, I'd imagine. Nelios says, I'm currently playing on second and 2 hours with a network save straight after the accident, managing on adrenaline. Oh, Jesus. Oh, JM played straight on. Sorry, I thought you said I played. Yeah. Yeah, JM's just he's like RoboCop, I think, JM, a little bit. You know. Yeah, I thought Julian Dix would be up your street, Dave, could you? Again, like, you don't find players like Julian Dix anymore. Like, someone who's essentially just a darts player. Like, who goes, you know what, I'll have a go at football. You know, all right, Julian, what's your current, how many years have you played football? Football? No, mate, I used to be a doorman. That's my thing. I used to be a doorman. I've got a pair of football boots, so I'm basically... going to fulfill the role of I can punch people or kick things really hard. Favourite West Ham player I've ever seen live. Like, he's just... You had to see him to believe him, didn't you, Dave? Like, because particularly now, for, like, younger viewers who may be watching this going, like, who or what is Julian Dix? Like, you can't... You would never get a player like him nowadays. He was very much a player of his time, but what a player. What a player. Hell of a shot on him as well. There you go. The skin is the Renzi Dark Skin. We like the Renzi Dark Skin. We also like the Tato Skin as well, which I would recommend people have a look at also. But yeah, he had a hell of a free kick on Julian Dix, which is bizarre because you'd think that usually, I mean, clearly he smoked, right? Clearly, like, just by looking at him, you go, smoker. Like, sometimes you wonder just whether he could even run up to take the free kick. But apparently he could. Absolute force of nature, an underrated footballer as well as hard man. Yeah, this is the thing. I think, like, people forget that he actually could play a bit as well. You know, that's the thing. He could do it. But I guess it's easy to sort of, like, dismiss that, isn't it, when you're in a team with Ian Dowie and who else did they have? Did they have Ruddock? I want to say they had Ruddock. It was Glenn Roeder. Used to fancy a bit of a tackle as well, didn't he? He was West Ham, wasn't he, Dave? Was he John Hartson in there as well? Al Berkovich. Glenn Roeder sure was, yeah. Ludek McCloskey. Who was right back? Ian Pearce, yes. Ian Pearce was another man who loved a bit of violence. Hearts and Dowie, yeah. Florin Radichoyu. I mean, not really one for getting his feet in there, but he was the guy who was clearly in the wrong place. Tim Breaker, oh, forgot all about Tim Breaker. In fact, you know what? Why would anyone remember Tim Breaker unless you were a West Ham fan? It's not. I'm guessing nobody in the chat sitting there going, he hasn't mentioned Tim Breaker yet. But don't worry, Dave Goodger has. Dave Goodger's mentioned Tim Breaker. I think who else would sort of be like players who just sort of players you think you've forgotten and then they rock up again. Was there anyone more violent than Souness? Souness was, he was a proper cunt, wasn't he? Like, just angry man. John Moncur was brilliant. He was brilliant. Stanton with a goal. John Moncur was good. I liked him. Proper no-nonsense. Like, you know, you've got no-nonsense centre-backs in Football Manager now. He was a no-nonsense midfielder. That's a role they should have, shouldn't it? Just... I mean, to be fair, Kevin Ball should have played for West Ham at some point, really, shouldn't he? He'd have settled in nicely. This is more like it, Norwich. Oh, apparently not. Head's gone straight to a Coventry player, Gambos now. Papanga. Intercepted back. Here's a question for everyone, right? Who is the worst player? Oh, who's the worst player that's ever played for your football team? And then conversely, who's the best player that's ever played for your football team? It'd be interesting to see the disparity between the best player and the worst player. Harry Maguire, best player clearly. Apocalypse. I'm guessing he's a Sheffield United fan. Evening, Andrew. How are you? Welcome. Nice to see you. Ian Dowie. Again, I'm not saying whether that's best player or worst player. And Bobby Moore. So I'm guessing Dowie then for worst player, possibly. Emmanuel Riviere. Go. Missed the penalty. Harry Maguire's the worst player in the history of any club. Not really. He was good at Sheffield United. And to be fair, he's not even the worst player in Man U's history. He's certainly not Eric Jemba or Massimo Taibbi or David Bellion. He's not even as bad as Karol Poborski. You know what I mean? Leo Twitch, how are you? Welcome. Marega and Falcao. Okay, so Falcao, that must mean you're Atletico Madrid, maybe? Am I thinking? Pretty sure Riviere's only league goal was a miskick. Yeah, quite possibly. Boomsong and Bramble. Porto. Sorry, my mistake. Oh, just click that. Sorry. Porto, yeah. Porto have had some decent players, haven't they? Didn't you have Carvalho? I'm sure. Shefty Kuki. That's a bad one. Ferguson with a lovely header there as well. 2-0 now. Dowie was appalling when he played for us. Had some crackers as well. You guys had some absolutely mad heads though, Dave, at West Ham. Shefty Kuki was not the best Andy Carroll replacement. Yeah. Carvalho, the centre back. Yeah. Did he come from Porto? Or have I got myself wildly confused again? He was a hell of a player, Carvalho. And you had Quaresma as well. I loved Quaresma. You do make really good defenders. And you had Deco. You had that Porto side that Mourinho won the Champions League with was full of talent. Deco, Quaresma, I mean, and Carvalho. Yes, please, I'll have a bit of that, thank you. And was it Paulo Ferreira? Was it right back? Some reasonable talent right there. Part of me wants to say you had Benny McCarthy as well, but I don't know whether that was true or not. Jorge Andrade. Yes. Yes, Eris. Now we're talking. Yeah, you're right, Bobby. That poor team was insane, wasn't it? Like, I bet, like, Mourinho, like, couldn't believe his luck with that team. Just like, ooh, look what we've managed to create here. Just like, yes. Vita Bahia in goal, I think. Again, it's just literally just go back through the past and go like, what are the old players? Who's good? There you go, 4-0. The Portuguese Galacticos. Yeah, yes, that's exactly what it was. Villas Boas was insane as well. Falcao, Hulk, James Rodriguez, Garin, Pepe. Yeah. Yeah. Like, yeah, Porto were decent, aren't they? Porto were definitely decent. Yeah, we like Porto. We've got a lot of love for them over here. We're fine with that. Speaking of guns, Pepe, yeah. Pretty much. This is pretty much how I've been spending my streams, 92 database, going, oh yeah, he was good. Yeah, oh yeah. It's 100% the way to do it, Dave. 100%. Pepe was great. Pepe was brilliant. If he's in your team, if you're playing against him, I imagine you would hate Pepe. And that's the whole point. You're meant to hate Pepe. And he loves that. He loves the fact that everyone hates him. But you need a player like Pepe in your team, don't you? He's still at Port, is he? Oh, of course he went back, didn't he? 39, still playing well. Yeah, kicking everything that moves. I'm trying to think who the worst player for Villa's been. There's been a few. Because the thing is, like, you don't just want to say that you just don't want to just pick a player who was crap. You want to pick the worst player. So you're sort of like thinking, well, you know, Didier Gat was like, he was terrible, but he wasn't even the worst player that we've had. Like, Eric Jemba was bad, but I don't even think he's the worst player that Villa ever had. Who would be the worst player? I mean, Bosco Balaban seems like too easy. But Heskey's dreadful. Heskey was dreadful because of the fact that we were offered the chance to sign Falcao instead. So that's what makes Heskey even worse. So for the same price, for £4 million, Villa could have signed Falcao or Heskey, and they chose Heskey. And it's just like, I just don't understand how that's a bit of business you do, to be honest. I don't get how that conversation's happened. To go like, yeah, Heskey's a great idea. I tell you who the worst player was, right? And this is probably going to... Stephen Ireland? Just... crap. Absolute crap. Part of the deal to take James Milner away. So we lost James Milner, which is bad enough. Then we got given Stephen Ireland on massive wages, who didn't care and didn't want to play. So that was a dreadful, dreadful piece of business. We all know who the worst manager ever is. Oh, don't worry about the worst manager ever. We know about that, Ricky. Yeah, we know about that. He's still in a job, sadly. He's now worse than Tim Sherwood. Stephen, I don't want to play because my nan died Ireland. Yeah, Stephen, I don't want to play because, oh, my car's too purple. Ireland. Like, do you know what I mean? Like, just shit, really. Blackburn got offered Zidane once back in the 90s. Blackburn chairman turned it down and said, why do we need Zidane? We've got Tim Sherwood. I mean, to be fair, like, he's right, you know. They're playing completely different positions, so you wouldn't play Zidane where Tim Sherwood played. But, again, like, football's just littered with those moments in it of teams who nearly signed players. And, like, Cantona was on trial. Cantona was on trial at Sheffield Wednesday. Didn't get a game for Sheffield Wednesday before he went to Leeds. The reason that Sheffield Wednesday didn't sign him was they played a friendly on a plastic pitch back in the day when you could play plastic pitches. And they said, oh, we don't always like on grass. So Leeds signed him instead. Then a year later, he went to Man United. I love that story. Newcastle turned down Modric because he's too small. Yeah. Lewandowski was on his way to Blackburn with the volcano. Yeah, the ash cloud, wasn't it? Ibrahimovic has been offered to many clubs as well. He nearly signed for several clubs. Ruud van Nistelrooy nearly went to Sunderland before he did his knee injury. Here's your boy, by the way, Dave Goodger. Here's Jorge Hargreaves, is coming from West Ham, £8 million. Mahrez had a trial with St Mirren. Yes, he did, didn't he? And they turned him down. Mm-hmm. These are the stories. These are the stories we want. Borough Scouts turned down Kante. Did they? I mean, it sounds believable. It sounds believable. I mean, Villa didn't sign Frank Lampard from West Ham because Doug Ellis didn't want to pay an extra £500,000 or something. So he went to Chelsea. Villa also missed out on Bergkamp. Which is a bit of a, I still hate the fact they missed out on Bergkamp. What could have been? And Janinho, and Gascoigne, all those players were like sort of, yeah, they can just about get signed, and then they all went off somewhere else. Life could have been so different. I always find it interesting to the FM Jellicoe when one or more teams tells a player no, then they go to another team and it's pretty good. Yeah. Like, I guess it's like certain players either just find the right team to play with, or they've got enough. So I'll show you. Do you know what I mean about them? And you get moments like that, which is great. But some players just fit a certain team, don't they? Standing up to Ferguson. He's already had the ball in the net. It's been disallowed though. Standing, weaving his magic back inside. But Hargreaves. That's damn. Oh, I thought Baptista played the ball through there. Oh, Ferguson's won that back nicely. Oh, ooh. What a goal that would have been. That's what we like about Hargreaves. Ferguson puts his defensive duties in, doesn't he? Puts his shift in. Here's Baptista with the corner. Heads away. Okay, a bit of encouragement. We're still top at the minute. Still top at the minute. These are nervy games, these derby matches. Especially when they've already beaten us on stream tonight. A lot of movement going on up front, but we're not getting the ball there, are we? Stanton. Oh, he's dropped it. Keeper's dropped it. Ferguson's put it in the net. Taps it in. That'll do. It's been all Norwich, hasn't it? It's been all Norwich. Footballers looking opportunities. Couldn't agree more, Leo. Couldn't agree more. 100% in it. Be in the right place at the right time. That's what it's all about. Sunderland are currently drawn with Bristol City, which for us puts us in the right place at the right time. We go top of the table now, 86 points. Remember, folks, this was a team that when we joined were 21st in the league. Oof. We saved them last season. We got them to 11th, and then we started this season on fire. We just kept going, to be honest. I say 21st, but actually 23rd, I think we took them over, wasn't it? We were in the relegation zone, I think we were. Maybe they had pulled themselves out slightly, but yeah, no regrets for leaving Bolton at this point. Oof. That was close. They're getting the old goal line technology out there. They go like, did that go in? Like, I don't know. Maybe it did. I'm not saying it didn't, but, you know, we'll have to see. Massive transfer window if we go up. I think you're right, Bulby. Like, we'll chuck a... It depends. Like, if we get a lot of money, it'll be great. If not, it's going to have to be smart loans, I think. It's going to be interesting to see what they give us. That's a hell of a strike. That is a hell of a strike. If Fair play, John Vargas. I think they've been better in the second half, haven't they? We've not really been in it. He's got far too much space. We've still got a lot to do from there, though. What jobs have we had? So we started the save unemployed. We went to Brackley for 4 years, Jack. Then we went to York City. So we had two seasons at York where we won the National League North playoffs. And then we won the National League playoffs. So we did back-to-back promotions, got ourselves into League Two. Enjoyed our time. We were there for about 12 games or something into League Two. Then we went to Bolton. And it was in the Championship, so we managed to get ourselves a promotion at the Championship. Did okay first season, that was fine. And then second season, we were sort of doing okay, but there was rumours of discontent amongst the playing staff. So we threw our toys out the pram and left to join Norwich, who, as we say, was sat, I think, 21st or 23rd in the table. Finished the season in 11th, so we finished above Bolton. So, again, we justified going. And this season, obviously, we're into what looks like the Premiership with York's with Norwich. So, not too bad for 9 seasons, I think, really. We've done it. We've played the slow game. You know, it's not been a sort of like, let's get ourselves quick fire, bang, bang, bang. But, yeah, we've had fun doing it. Taking our time. It's been a nice sort of like end of cycle save here. Sunderland are a goal down against Bristol City, and they've had a man sent off as well. So that's very, very interesting. We're 2 points clear. There you go. We can be the best manager in East Anglia again now. Jack, I did the same. We're starting the Welsh lower leagues now at Wrexham in the fifth season. Excellent. Love that. Love that. We're trying to do the British Steel Challenge, Jack, in FM23. So we have to try and win every trophy that's available or get promoted from every single league. And we're expecting that will start the challenge in Lower League Wales or Lower League Northern Ireland, because I've got a feeling that's how cruel the game's going to be to us. But I did a Wales save a couple of years ago. It was FM19, I think it was. That was banger. I thoroughly enjoyed it. So did I actually tell you the reason that we're doing British Steel, by the way? I can't remember if I did or not, but the plan was, I was thinking about doing either a Build a Nation Save in Wales or a Build a Nation Save in Scotland. I thought that would be the way to do it. And then ultimately the British Steel sort of just is a nice way of trying to do either of those nations, because we're going to be there for a while regardless. So it's not going to be the Build a Nation, but we are going to be there for a long time. So we do get that kind of affiliation with teams as well and the league. So Wales is very tough. Wales is very, very tough. TNS are the team to take down. Agreed. And as well, it's that thing of like just picking up the right players, like having players who are just on amateur contracts. Second you turn professional, then it's great. Like loads of like Italian players in Bangor. Cardiff Met Uni, trying to get as many of their players as possible because they get some decent players. Northern Ireland is ripe for talent on the game as well. So I'm looking forward to seeing how we get on over there. 2, 4, 6, 8 games in the next hour. We're going to be pushing it. But let's see if we can do it. But yeah, I can't wait. I think the British Steel is going to be super tough, but it's going to be fun at the same time. West Brom. So hopefully we can get a result here as well. Just need to keep winning at this point. That's all we have to do. Keep winning, keep winning, keep winning. Keep Sunderland out of the way. Where are they playing? They're playing Crystal Palace away. West Brom are obviously up there in the playoff mix as well. We're just about over the line, I would say, in terms of the playoffs. What's that? 22 points clear now? I think we're probably in the playoffs. I think. Actually, no, it'd be 7 games would be 21 points. Yeah, okay, so we're still not mathematically in the playoffs yet. If we win here, then we're definitely in the playoffs. I didn't piss everyone off by telling them we're playing well. It's first for everything. Let's put Adam Ida on. Ida, as he's called, sorry. No income anywhere in Wales, which adds to the difficulty. Yeah, exactly. And there's amateur teams, well, like all of Division 2 is amateur, I believe. Is that right? And I'm pretty sure that in Northern Ireland, I'm sure that there's a rule where everyone has to have £250 contract. That's it. So it's like, who do you get for 250 quid? It's like managing like in the sort of the tier 10 database when that gets made, and like you just have to sort of survive on non-contracted players. It becomes a much more tricky challenge, but it's good though. It's where all the fun is. It's what we find fun anyway. We find it fun around here. You know, we're in for the grind. Palace are beating Sunderland. That's good news. We need to just keep this as it is though. If we can. Who else can come on? Maybe not Howarth. Jed, possibly. Actually, Howarth might have to come on. Well, Steve Kiley can go on as a... See if we can hold, grind this one out. Apocalypse, you heard your name. Possibly. I can't. I'm trying to think of the context, but... Nicely nodded down. Just keep the ball, boys. That's all we have to do. Nothing silly. Here comes a 40 through to Ida. Yes! That could be the goal that confirms that we're definitely in the playoffs. Definitely in the playoffs of the Premier League. Lovely ball. Great run round the back. What a finish that is. I know Keg says it's Ida, but I'm still saying Ida. Raided Cardiff Union, Swansea Uni, okay, there's an option as well. Yeah, Cardiff Met always have some great players. Virtually promoted. I think we are, yeah. Yeah, I would say we're... I mean, it's going to be... What's that? Still 17 points clear of West Brom. I mean, even for me, that's a hell of a bottle job to drop out of the top two, isn't it? It's not. I mean, it's not impossible for me to bottle it, but it's starting to look like we're probably in there. So we've got the playoff spot secured. That's good. I don't know how you say it. Nice work, Scott Chapman. Welcome in. Hope you're well. So there you go. So the playoffs are locked in. We've got that. That's a thing, right? Assuming this game is no longer Steve Bruce in charge of West Brom. No, not at all. Not at all. He's long gone. Who is in charge of West Brom, actually? West Brom is Igor Tudor. So a former Juventus player, I believe, from back in the days of Championship Manager. Not the player I was expecting to be in charge, if I'm honest. Not the player. Chapman 0102 legend. Absolutely, come on the rocks. Welcome, by the way. Sorry, I didn't quite clock who was in there, so hope you're well, buddy. Nice to see you in. Hope life's treating you good. Jack Devlin, look at my goalkeeper, my second full season in Wales, a 15-year-old regen who was a leading Premier League player and just saved everything. This is the thing, innit? If you can get one or two players, all you need is one or two, and they can just carry you. You know, if they're better than everybody else, particularly a goalkeeper or a striker, then that'll be what you want, innit? You know? Far too good for West Brom. They deserve Megson or joking here. That physio that accidentally got the Charlton Southampton job that one time. I mean, I can't disagree with anything you're saying there. Set for record points haul still. We're ploughing on. Because the thing is, like, as long as it is looking likely that we're going to get promoted,
right?
But we still be nice to get the league title, wouldn't it? Five clear of Sunderland now. Five clear. I mean, can we keep pushing around? Can we keep pushing? Hopefully. Tiptoeing around any kind of certainty in case the inevitable bitch slap from karma. Oh, like, you know what? I'm not getting anywhere near this. Come on, the rocks. I am not convinced. Until it says you have been promoted, I'm not believing a word of it. Like, how much do we get for getting promoted in the Premier League? We should get a reasonable amount, to be honest. Probably less than if we get promoted via the playoffs, because that's obviously the thing they say is where the richest game in football, isn't it? So I think we also have to work out as well what the board will give us in terms of transfer money. I would say we're probably going to get something like 40 million. 1-0. I'd say maybe something like 40 mil for transfers. If it's anything less than 20, then I think we have to... I think we maybe have to look for a new club. If it's anything less than 20 mil. See with the loanee, if you have a toss-up between them and a contract player, do you find yourself dropping the loanee more often? In terms of playing, depends upon what the agreement is with the loan. Like, if I'm paying for them to be an unused substitute or not used, then sometimes the loanee will play. Usually if I've got a loanee player in, my thinking behind it is that they are a player who's better than what I've currently got. They're from the division above, so all of our players we've got on loanees here are from Liverpool and Man City. 2-0. So we've got that there that's going to be... So they're going to play, basically, because they're better than the players we've currently got. Great finish. You don't quite get that in FM 16. Got you. We've got 92 points now. This has been quite the season, to be honest. I don't think this team would do that bad in the Premier League. I genuinely think that... I'm trying to think. It's probably... one or two players, I think, that maybe not Premier League level. We'd maybe have to replace Baptiste. And maybe Barr? I don't know. Oh, Ferguson, what a strike that is. I'm starting to think Ferguson's now been a bit of like tidy business as well. Did all the tedious work of praising training. Not at the minute, we're not, Jack. We have done in the past to get to this point, but to be fair, the last few streams, we've just kind of like looked at our clock and went, ooh, beta's coming soon. We need to get through this quick. So we have done it in the past and praised training and it does work. But at the minute, we're just literally just powering through, like just random clicks on press conferences. Tipple makes it 4. 20 minutes in, we're 4-0 up against Bristol City. This is ridiculous football. Absolutely ridiculous football. Playing as Vardos, there's an annoyingly slim number of Swiss players for the homegrown rules. So sign some loanies and who now will hate me because I'd rather play my own players. Yeah, that's not what you want, is it? You don't want that. Oh, look at it. Norwich ball. It is incredible. Not used to seeing you in the Premier League, sports mad. I've got a nosebleed, mate. I don't know what's going on now. We're 5-0. We've only played 25 minutes against Bristol City. Look at this. 1 point from safety. 1 point from clinching promotion, apparently, according to Boltby. Didn't come here for competence. No one did. Come on the rocks. Everyone's here to watch the collapse. To watch us go, like, we had 92 points. And just how... when did it slip away? That's what we're here for. Oh, saw a Reddit post today with a macro to do it auto. I set it up, it's amazing. Definitely the first thing I'm setting up for FM23. Oh, that's interesting. I'll tell you what, Devlin, stick that up in our Discord. There's a little section we've got called, I'll find where it should probably go. FM resources, that's a good place for it to go in the Discord. So yeah, if you pop that up in there, then I think that'll be a nice thing that I think people would be quite interested to have a look at. So I mean, yeah, 5-0, let's just feet up now, lads. Nothing else to do, is there? Like the fact that Sam Redmond's on a 6.4, so we'll have to bring him off. Oof. Pick that one out. Pick that. It's offside. Oh, what a strike. That had flames on it. Absolute flames on it. Yeah, you gotta be good. Gotta be good about that. Yeah, 6.4 and a 5-0 win. He's been shinned every ball at the stands. To be honest, I just think he's not been involved. He's the right back. Like, I don't think we've been under any pressure. So he's not actually had to do anything. So the games just went, well, you've clearly not been involved. You know, he's just sat having a pie. Borges goes close. So we're currently 5 points clear of Sunderland, because Sunderland, I think, must be winning, are they? Excellent win. We haven't been promoted yet, I don't think. Otherwise, it would have said congratulations on the promotion. Maybe it's the next match. Maybe it's the next match and we'll do it. Sunderland has secured a playoff spot. Bars out for 2 weeks. It's fine. We're getting there. Keep clicking. Just keep clicking. This seems to be working for us. Random clicks work. 14 more days till Bournemouth. Come on. What are we going to do with ourselves? 14 days. 2, 4, 6 games. 6 games still to play. Bournemouth, Birmingham, Nottingham Forest. Games that we need to get these points just to ensure we get the title. We're going to hit the 100, right? No sleep till Bournemouth. Watford have sacked a manager, in case anyone's remotely interested, because of course they have. Marcus Leonardo, they're saying we should definitely get. He's never going to come to us. He's never going to come. That's what we got. Bournemouth, Birmingham, Forest, Bolton away, Sunderland at home, Palace away. I mean, we're going up, right? We're going up. This is the thing. It's happening. We are definitely getting promoted. Are we going up as champions? That's what we need to work out. Aldershot have made an approach for Niall Leonard. That's fine. Let him go. He can do that if he wants. He said it. Evening, Ali. If Gerrard gets sacked, will he be a Villa fan again? I'd certainly be more inclined to be a Villa fan again. Yeah. Absolutely. And that's six increasingly chastening defeats. It's going to happen, isn't it? We know this is what's happening. We can't turn it off now. That's the problem. We can't turn the stream off, because if we do, then we know we're not going to win any of those games. So we sort of have to really play the next six matches, whether I want to or not. How are you, Ali? Anyway, are you well? Good to have you back in. Adam Ida scored goals. Good. Yeah, fingers crossed Gerrard's out of the club shortly, but I can't see it. That's the problem. I think Perslow's too stubborn, and I think the club needs to just take that decision out of his hands. No, nah, he's going. This whole vanity project hasn't worked. You've posted it up. Lovely. Appreciate that, Jack. Reckon he lasts till the pre-the World Cup. I can sort of see that. But then there's also an argument for saying get rid of him before the World Cup, so that the new manager can come in and start scouting for players at the World Cup, which is always a terrible time to buy players. It's terrible to buy players for an international tournament. Everyone knows this. But it would then give that manager a bit of time to work with the players who don't go to the World Cup and have 4 weeks of just drilling down, which I think would be probably a good idea, to be honest. I've heard the MRA rumours as well, actually. Ali, I don't... For me, I think that like MRA would be amazing, don't get me wrong. I don't think we go for Emery. I think we go for Sean Dyche. Personally, I think that's the... It sounds really stupid if there's an option for Unai Emery, and I'm not sure if there is an option for Unai Emery. But I would be going all out for... Emery would obviously want to wait until the World Cup, I presume, so he doesn't want any sort of distraction from... is it Seville? I think he's currently at. Is it Sevilla? Plus, I mean, realistically, why would he want to join? Like, why would he want to join Villa from Seville? You know, it don't make any sense, really. Whereas Sean Dyche would, you know, he'd get us grafting, is what it would be. That's the thing. Now you'll see Leicester need a Dyche. Villarreal, yeah. I knew he was one of those teams that wins the Europa League a lot. It's either Sevilla or Villarreal. But, I mean, I guess the fact that it's got Villa in the title is probably why you might go. Just be like, yeah, it's fine, I'll go to Villarreal because it's almost the same club, maybe. But, yeah, like, Villa and Leicester need to fight over Sean Dyche and just go, right, who's getting the guy who's going to try and just basically keep them in the division? Also add to the fact that Wolves are in for a manager as well. You know, Forest might look for someone shortly as well. Yeah, duke it out, exactly like doing the playground, right? Taps off, fight till the death. finally got to the Bournemouth game. Finally. And I think this might be, this might be, it's just said there, if we win, we get promoted. If we win. Scott, as you refresh the stream, we're basically saying it's between us and Leicester, need a Sean Dyche, essentially. We need to start fighting it out. We're going to organise a scrap over on the school fields. Whoever wins gets Sean Dyche, taps off. It's the only way to do it. England crash out in the World Cup's quarterfinals. Dyche gets the England job. Oh, that'd be brilliant. Immediately all players get to get short back and sides and wear black football boots. England wins 70 games in a row. Yeah, that's the thing. That's the only other way, isn't it? That Sean Dyche either goes to Villa or Leicester or goes to England. And you've then got the problem that if he goes to England, then that means that Gareth Southgate goes to Villa. Although he didn't leave Villa very nicely. You know, went off to Middlesbrough to win trophies, apparently. Didn't happen, did it? Oh! What a ball. What a ball from Ferguson. He can supply as well as score goals. Stanton at the back post smashes it in. Oh, Newcastle won't go for Southgate, Dave. They'll pay money for someone like, if Pochettino's still out of a job, they'll go for Pochettino. Or, the murderers will go out and buy some big name manager or something. They'll kidnap Ancelotti or something. Yeah. I'm with you, come on the rocks as well. Give me Scotland for internationals, but give me Sean Dyche in charge of everything. Dyche for Barcelona. Incredible. We've already discussed Dyche at Man City. The only manager in the world who tells Haaland to play with his back to goal. I think that's us. I think that could be us. Allegri to Newcastle, how goes nowhere? I mean, how would that work then? They can't both be there, surely. They can't be like co-managers. I mean, to be fair, Eddie Howe will go wherever Eddie Howe gets told to go, because that's what Eddie Howe clearly does. You know, old Eddie No Morals over there. Now we're talking apocalypse. Now we're talking the similarities between Cruyff and Dyche. Tell me about them. Sean Dyche's total football is a thing, of course. You know, if you're going to tell me that Johan Cruyff didn't actually use midfielders and Sean Dyche just bypasses the midfield, sort of makes sense. Dyche taking over a City and immediately signing J. Rodriguez to partner Haaland. Oh, Dominic Solanke. The Dyche turn. Oh, I love that. I love that. Yes, Dave Goodge has booked his hotel. Oh, right. If people don't know what Dave Goodge has booked a hotel for, Football Manager Therapy Live. I know I'm on the Football Manager show now, but we've had Football Manager Therapy booked in before I got announced on that. So there you go. Nottingham Comedy Festival. 7th of November, the day before the FM23 comes out. There's a live podcast, the Canal House in Nottingham. It's going to be great fun. I'm going to do an hour's worth of podcasting. Then we're going to basically have a meetup. FM meetup. It's going to be great fun. Come and get your tickets. We've already sold well over 50, which is we're very, very happy with, happy about. So, we didn't get the promotion. That's the turn you make after kicking the ball 60 yards down the field. Dice just happens to stay on his feet instead of falling down. And what he does, he boots it and he turns around and he just turns to the crowd like that, just like. That's the turn. I'm gonna see Rich Owens live. You can see Rich Owens live in person. You can see me live in person. You can see special guests. I sound like a WWE advert at this point, for like a touring live show, for the house show of like, come to see SmackDown at the Norwich Arena and the Grimsby Bowl. You can see Randy Orton. Are we up? Have we gone up? Have we? No, they've not. We've not gone up yet. We've got playoffs. If we'd have won, we'd have been automatically promoted. But unfortunately, it's still mathematically, Sunderland can still catch us. And it was the fact that Bournemouth drew, which has put them into the playoffs. So, not quite there yet. We're getting there. Obviously, we're up against Birmingham, who are second bottom. The collapse is happening. I can already see what's going on. I can already see it. See what you like about Johan Cruyff. We never got a tune out of Chris Wood. How many games we got to play now? We've got five to play. I think we're gonna struggle. I don't think we get five in tonight. Dice had a pub named after him. I've never heard of a pub called the Dog and Cruyff. The Red Cruyff and the Cruyff and Flag. Yeah, it's a good point. It's a very good point, actually. Point clinches the promotion, right? This is what we'll do then. If we get promoted tonight, this is it. Tomorrow, championship stream. And then obviously planning for the Premier League. Because yeah, so we've got to be up early in the morning to record the Football Manager show. Come on then, Norwich. What have we got? What have we got in the tank? 1 point. That's all we need against Birmingham. Please don't make us have to play all five matches to get 1 point. Please. It feels like something that we might have to do, but please not. Get in. Evan Ferguson. Thompson Brown. anything happening. Thompson Brown back to bar. Oof, Stanton with a decent effort. Oh, nice ball through. Small bones through. Great save by Ploog. Ball's headed away, Shaw. Challenger, good block. Cruyff was that good, he changed the way football was played and coached. Same as Sean Dyche. Same as Sean Dyche, exactly the same. Ooh, Tipple going close at the near post. Look at that, 26 points clear of Bournemouth. Unbelievable. Before Redmond picks it back up, before he puts it back to Stanton, who heads it over the top. Come on, we've got this. We've got this, Norwich. Surely we've got this. Surely. Forty-five minutes to go. If we can go up, can we see the budgets tonight? I don't think so. Because I think they'd end up giving you, I think you have to wait for it to pull through, don't you, before they give you the budget. Actually, it might do. I'm not convinced they do, but if it does, then that'd be great. Four, he's gone down. It's not a penalty, though, is it? Thompson Brown's got a little orange thing over his head. Ida. Four, Redmond. Stanton's not going to score from there, is he? Right. Change Stanton and Borges as well. Stanton's a bit tired. Head away nicely. Maybe need to change bar as well, actually. Oof. Who could put in Baptiste? There we go. Uh-oh. Bakuna should have scored that. Should have scored. Heads away. Got away again. Right. Down to the last 25 minutes. No, apparently a four didn't actually get a highlight there. Interesting. Redmond, Dam, Baptiste, Ferguson, Ida. Look how much space Redmond's got. Can he pick out Borges? Oh. Before it's still only 1-0. It's a bit nervy when it's only 1-0. Just worried that maybe we're not quite there yet. 18 shots, 10 on target. Still only 1-0. 4 minutes to go. Just don't do anything silly. Dwelling on the ball a little bit too much there, aren't we? That'll do. Nicely intercepted. Redmond. Ball over the top. Away goes Ferguson. Tackled. It's a long highlight. This is a long highlight. There's Ida. Afori. Borges! That's the goal. That's us promoted to the Premier League. The question now is, do we go up as champions or do we go up as second place? What a strike. We are Premier League. Absolutely. Absolutely apocalypse. We've done what is probably we would have thought would be impossible. Oh, it's not over yet. It's not over yet. Great strike. Brilliant piece of football. It got us there. Somehow it got us there. We're over the line. Redmond, Borges pulls it back. Ferguson off the post. Just counting the minutes down now. I think that's it. I think that should be it. Are we done? Pretty sure that's it. Yes. Promoted to the Premier League. There we go. What about that? Both of them promoted. Both of us. I don't know. I mean, I'm happy with that. We do get budgets. Let's see what we're going to get for next year. 39 million. 39? What do we think? Decent? Come on, regain a wave. That's what it says there. Woo way, says hooray for Norwich. Scott Chapman says, good work. £39 million, Boltby. That's not terrible. It's not the end of the world. We could do something with 39 million quid, I think. If we do some smart, I reckon, you know, smart loans should see us in there pretty handily. Yeah, I reckon we'll be all right. Nobody expected us to get that far, so that's pretty good. And what we got there? Four games left. I'll tell you what we'll do. Let's do the title party tomorrow night. Yeah? Sorry for coming late. I saw the game for $20 on Steam. Is it worth to buy, even though you can get to play FM23? I don't know, to be honest, Control Warrior. Yes, in a sense, I would say it definitely is still worth it. But you are right. FM23 comes out in a month. And you can get FM23 for £32 on... So I don't know what the dollar transfer rate is. So it is fairly cheap right now. Control Warrior, appreciate the follow. By Scott Chapman as well, appreciate the follow. So, yeah, I'm not... Personally, I would say it's definitely worth just waiting to get in the new game right now. It was free on Prime Gaming, so that's definitely worth a shout. But, yeah, I think probably wait. I'll say probably wait. We're going to go and drop a raid now. We're going to hang out with Fudge Waffles, who's got a Paris save going on at the minute. It's not Paris Saint-Germain, it's Paris FC, so we like that one. Go and give them some love, and we will come back tomorrow for the title pie. Take care. Norwich City are Premier League.